Challenging years make us think a different way. When we think about a challenging year, how we respond, sometimes even react to that year can make or break our business. I mean, it's very easy to fall into the negative mindset, the frustration, the isolation of a year, like a lot of you have seen. It's easy. But when we start visualizing the negativity, when we start visualizing the things that won't work, things that are breaking, things that won't come to fruition the way we anticipate, when we start looking for problems, and not problems to fix, but actually looking for problems, what ends up happening so many times is we're actually visualizing the lack of success that we're going to get. We're going to get what we visualize. And it's been a cool year when you talk to so many business owners, because I've had the pleasure of being able to consult with so many successful business owners this year, and some that have been more challenged. But the successful ones, I mean, they're the pizza place on the corner that went to straight takeout immediately. They changed their entire way of doing business. Something they chose they would never do in the beginning, that they flipped on a dime to be able to serve people and saw more business this year. They're the restaurant that built outdoor seating because that was the only way to serve people. And they did things that took them to a different level. They realized that they couldn't do face-to-face appointments the way that they used to. You know, people in our industry, if you're an advisor, if you're an insurance, if you're a lawyer, any professional services, part of what we do is serve people. When you can't serve people sitting across the desk from them, it's a pretty big challenge. If you visualize all the things you can't do, though, and you don't turn it into a solution, we can get caught up in the visualization of something that we don't want. And let's be frank, there were days this year where I felt that way, where I definitely got into a spot for a day or two where I was like, oh my gosh, are we kidding? I mean, when we had the entire shutdown and life stopped, that's an enormous challenge. The way I felt I could dig out the best was go to work, work harder, work smarter, evaluate all the things that we could do. So in a moment where you're shut down with all these things you can't do, what I saw so many business owners do, what I tried to do personally, was really lay out all the things that I could do. I actually did a T-chart, and I wrote down all the things that I normally do, and then I wrote down all the things that I still could do, or how I could take the things we were doing before and flip them to something I can do now. It's visualizing the success that I wanted to see. It's the business owners that visualize the results. They were sitting 30,000 feet above, and they were looking down at all the great things that were going to happen. Even if it continued to be challenging, they were going to keep rolling with the punches. And, you know, that was my logic. And if you're watching this today, 95% of you, I guarantee it's yours as well. You went fighting this year. You were not going down. Even if you were on your back in moments, you were fighting. And sometimes when you fight, you take a couple punches, but you walk out victorious, because what you learned is how to avoid those punches in the future. What you learned is how to visualize the results that you're aiming for and to not get pushed off course, to not let anything or anyone or any challenge take you off your course. And when I see failure is a word that so often is equated with negativity and bad stuff, but failure is a way that we learn. Again, I've used this quote a million times. I love it. John Maxwell says, sometimes you win, sometimes you learn. This year was a lot of learning. And if we were smart, we took that learning and we really developed it into our next plan, into our next chapter. That chapter may look completely different for you. It doesn't look completely different for us, but it's so much clearer today than I ever thought it would be based on the challenges that we all lived in the previous year. This is a message that goes on in perpetuity, no matter what year it is, because every year, every one of us is going to have a challenge. And how we come out of it is so imperative to visualize the success we want. I don't tell my boys when they go into a soccer game to think about them missing the big goal. You know, the few penalty kicks that I've seen them miss, we talk about it, and you know what they tell me? Dad, I was just wondering about where the goalie was going to go. Guess what they weren't focusing on? What they can control. I can control where I put the ball. I can control the deep breath I take before and the deep breath I let out. And I can control where I'm going to place that ball. It's the only things I can control. And if I'm only focused on that, if I miss, I miss. But I did every single thing I could, and I visualized success. I love thinking about making the penalty kick before we even get into the game. I talk about that with them. We talk about that together. I think about those things in business. I see Freedom Street 3 years from now. I see it 5 years from now. I see it 10 years from now. It's not always exactly how I envisioned it, but it's pretty close. And I hope that it stays as successful as it's been. So if you're a business owner and you find yourself getting in that mode of failure and negativity, and it's pushing you back to visualize all the things that aren't working in your business, flip it, flip it. It's time to flip it. Flip it to positivity. Flip it to reality. I'm not saying optimism's always the way either. You can't optimize and smile your way out of the worst situations, you know, but you can think strategically. You can take everything you know in the moment, in the reality, and figure out how you're going to move forward. Do the very best you can. And if you fail, you fail forward. So what a great year to have failed forward. I share all of your challenges, and I've listened, and I've learned so much this year, and I can't wait to listen and learn more moving into the next year. So I'm Scott Danner with Freedom Street Partners. Visualizing the success that you want is the key. Not visualizing the negative result that you may see, but that you can overcome. Thanks for joining me.